गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 10, टुडे वी विल टेक द क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑफ द पोयम द एनिमल्स. नोटिस द यूज ऑफ द वर्ड टर्न इन द फर्स्ट लाइन. आई थिंक आई कुड टर्न एंड लिव विद एनिमल्स. व्हाट इज द पोयम टर्निंग फ्रॉम? द पोएट विशेष टू टर्न अवे फ्रॉम द डिप्रेसिंग वर्ल्ड ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स एंड लिव विद एनिमल्स ऑन एन इक्वल फुटिंग. ही इज सिक ऑफ द वर्ल्ड ऑफ मेटेरियलिज्म. ह्यूमन बींग्स हैव द मेनिया ऑफ ओइंग थिंग्स. दे आर वेरी सेल्फिश एंड फॉल्स. वेयर एज एनिमल्स आर सेल्फ सेटिस्फाइड एंड जेन्युइन. द ह्यूमन बींग्स हैव बी False respectability, whereas animals go by their instinct. Now see second question. Mention three things that humans do and animals don't. There are many things that humans beings do but animals cannot. Humans keep on complaining but about their condition, but animals don't complain. Humans have a sense of being sinful, but animals don't have any such feeling. Humans think that they have a duty towards God, but animals have no such thoughts. Now see next question. Do humans kneel to other humans who lived thousands of years ago? Discuss this in group. Yes, humans do kneel to other humans who lived long, long ago. They have a respectful attitude to their ancestors who lived in the distant past. They have a sense of tradition, respect for old custom, ritual and ceremonies. Animals on the other hand live in the present. They are not bound by the past. Next question is, what are the tokens that the poet says he may have dropped long ago and which the animals have kept for him? Discuss this in class. The word token refers to those characteristics which animals still preserve and which have been lost by the humans. According to Darwin, human beings have evolved from lower animals like apes and donkeys. Darwin's theory of evolution proves that man is also an animal. The only difference is that human beings have made a lot of progress in their effort to civilize themselves. However, human beings have lost certain characteristics which other animals can retain. Those characteristics are self-satisfaction, contentment, feeling of guilt, etc. English is a funny language, funny, but because if the plural of tooth is teeth, why isn't the plural of booth is big? As you know that it is a very funny language. Now, what is the message of the poem Animals? Can you tell me? Human beings should be calm and contented. Sadly, most of us remain unhappy and stressful for one reason or the other. We continue to make complaints or grieve over one shortage or the other. But animals do not weep. They do not pester themselves thinking over duty they are God. We human beings remain guilt-ridden. What is worse is that we remain obese with the idea of possessing more and more things. We have become greedy. Animals have no such obsession. It is strange that we discriminate one person from the other on many grounds. We do not follow the spirit of equality among ourselves. So the poet wants to convey us the message that we human beings should learn a lot from animals and try to regain those animals' qualities like simplicity, innocence and honesty, etc. Now students, I think you are able to understand this poem and question answer of this. Thank you.